UPDF started the operation codenamed Usalama Kwa Wote in 2021, ridding the Karamoja sub-region of deadly cattle raids and criminality. According to the 3rd Division Commander, Major General John William Navaza, among the achievements UPDF has registered are the recovery of stolen livestock, the arrest of 29,321 cattle rustlers, the recovery of 1,174 guns, and the recovery of 9,217 live ammunition. He highlighted the challenge of porous border points, however, gave assurance that the UPDF is acting to heighten the monitoring efforts.
I wake up and say, I've given myself 1 month, or 1 year, I must get rid of all the firearms and put a stop to proliferation of small arms. Why? The border is so porous. Anybody can enter from anywhere, as and when. So what are we doing? The UPDF leadership is advancing. We are building more capacity to ensure that all those porous borders are closely monitored.
The Assistant Commissioner of Police, ACP Francis Temusto, Commandant of the Anti-Stock Theft Unit, ASTU, said the most common crimes in this region are cattle rustling, murders and poaching. He further added that these crimes are influenced by excessive alcohol consumption among Karamojong warriors.
It was observed that when warrage is taken, one's judgment tends to get false confidence that he can do anything.
The fire broke out yesterday in the Kisenya suburb in Kampala, leaving property in 10 shops and businesses destroyed, with the most of the affected being Somali business owners. The fire is suspected to have spread fast from a nearby makeshift restaurant, which is located near Haas fuel station. Residents lauded the police for the quick intervention in putting out the fire, which they say would have caused a catastrophe because of the nearby fuel station. Residents, however, expressed concern over the mushrooming fuel stations in the suburbs.
Zino makeshift. Mulimu wali congestion mungi nyo. So, umuneku spread inze nyo, let make the shunt to disable inze.
A Zibola yesterday held funeral procession for people killed in the pager blast in Beirut. The wireless devices used by Zibola combatants, health workers and administrative staff exploded across Lebanon on Tuesday, killing 12 people and wounding around 2,800, according to the official figures. The simultaneous explosion of hundreds of pagers used by Zibola members has massively hindered the group's communications and could undermine its operations against Israel in Lebanon's south, according to analysts. The nationwide blast marked the culmination of a series of escalating attacks on Hezbollah targets blamed on or claimed by Israel, including a July airstrike that killed senior military commander Fouad Shakur in Beirut's southern suburbs. The pager blast, described by a source close to Hezbollah as a major blow, came hours after Israel said it was broadening the aims of the Gaza war to include its fight against Hezbollah on its northern border. Hezbollah blamed the attacks on Israel, which has neither confirmed nor denied involvement in Tuesday's explosions.